Now that we've declared z to be an optional, let's try to use z in an operation. Let's take a look at this error. Here the compiler is telling us that z needs to be unwrapped. You can't use a present that's still wrapped. Now, to unwrap z, we could just follow the suggestion from the compiler and place an exclamation mark after z, like this. But when unwrapping optionals, we want to be as careful as possible. So we're going to learn the safest way to unwrap a variable. Here we can see that this 123 string will convert to an int with no problem. But what if we weren't so sure? Here is a scenario in which z might actually evaluate to nil. I've created an array with two items and an index that is randomly either 0 or 1. When I get this string from the array, I can't be sure whether it can be converted to an int value. I don't know whether z will be nil or not. How do we unwrap z safely so that we can use it in further operations? Swift uses the if-let construction to carefully unwrap optionals. Take the time to really study this expression. It'll come up frequently in your Swift projects. This is the expression that unwraps z and places the int into a plain old int variable. In this case, we named it int value, but there's not a strict naming convention. This unwrapping and initializing of int value is also a Boolean expression controlling this if. It serves two purposes. And it will only evaluate to true if the optional has an int value. If the optional stores nil, then the whole expression will evaluate to false. Inside the block, the variable int value has been initialized as an int and can safely be used, and we can use an else block for the nil case. To see both cases, you can rerun the playground. Just go up to the Editor's menu and click Execute Playground. You can see the result over here in the sidebar. Just click on this little eyeball. And I'll run it again. And again. Sometimes I get a value and sometimes I don't. In this example, I chose variable names to make the code easier to read. But a convention adopted by many developers is to name the unwrapped variable to match the wrapped variable, like this. This can be a little confusing at first, but you'll get used to it after you see it a few times. You don't have to adopt this convention, but you may find that it saves time. This way you don't have to come up with a new name for every unwrapped variable. Safely unwrapping optionals like this is a fundamental Swift skill, and one can't have too much practice. Let's walk through another example with UI image view. Here I've created a UI image view which has a UI image property. This UI image property is a UI image optional. In this example, we'd like to access the size property of this UI image optional. If I try to access the image property directly to get the size, the compiler complains. Since there's no guarantee that this image property contains a value, we'll need to unwrap it carefully. So we use if-let to declare a variable and initialize it with the unwrapped image property. If the image has a value, we can access its size. If the image is nil, we're still covered. Let's say we hadn't set the image yet. In that case, the else block gets executed. And here we can see the image hasn't been set. And if we do go ahead and set the image to something, here we can see its size. And now that it's unwrapped, we can also expand the image from within Playground.